This Equipment World video is brought to you by Chevron Delo 600 ADF Ultra Low Ash Diesel Engine Oil. It's time to kick some ash.
Hi everybody, welcome back to Equipment World. You're watching The Dirt. I'm your host Brian, and as you can see, we're in the middle of construction, so please excuse our mess as we move into our new studio. But that being said, we're coming at you today to talk about some really cool technology. We're talking about Rodradar, a ground-penetrating radar bucket that allows you to find utilities on your own without a locate service. And it actually works, and it's pretty stinking accurate. So without further ado, we're going to talk to Moshe with Rodradar about how the system works. So this is a really exciting product, but for people unfamiliar with Rodradar, can you give us just kind of a general overview as to how the system works and what it is?
So I'll start with just outlining the problem, okay? Everybody works around utilities, and we know that the information about utilities is poor, and we know that it forces everybody to work slow and be very, very careful and be inefficient. The reason for that is very simple, and that is because we cannot see into the ground. And this is exactly what Live Degrader does. It gives the operator, and I emphasize it gives the operator the ability to see into the ground while digging. Okay? And this is where we differ from anybody else that is dealing with utility strikes, is that we want to empower the operator, because the operator with the machine is the one that eventually hits the utilities and is the one that wants to prevent, to avoid hitting the utilities. So this is what we do. How did we do that? We embedded a sensor into a digging bucket. And it's just like the radar or the camera that you have in your car that makes you a better driver. This is a sensor that tries to make the operator a better operator.
Is this limited to finding utilities with a tracer wire or some sort of metal conductor, or is this going to find plastic and other, you know, fiber, for instance, that doesn't necessarily have a tracer running alongside it?
First of all, we know that we can detect any type of utility in any type of soil.
Wow.
Okay? Of course, if you have a tracer wire or something metal in this utility, it's going to be easier for the system to pick it up.
Sure.
Okay? We are very focused on the short range. We are worried about the next bite of the bucket. So, since this is what we're interested in, we are overcoming many of the limitations of ground penetrating radar. The physics didn't change, but we're looking close. We can detect things that are different from what the soil looks like to the radar from very short range, and we can make the decision whether it is a utility or not. By the way, we do it automatically. We don't need any technician to interpret. Our algorithm does it automatically and presents it to the operator in a meaningful way, in a way that they can operate upon.
So not being limited to only metal conductor type utilities or ones with tracer wires, it sounds like even if I don't hire a private locate, I could come out here to a private resident and start digging around, and I still know that as long as I have the Rodradar, I'm going to be okay finding those private utilities as well, because it doesn't discriminate between private and public.
It doesn't discriminate between private and public, and we do not intend to make things different or change the rules. If you are using a locator before and you think it's worthwhile to use a locator again, go ahead and do it. What we're doing is that once you get with your machine on this site and you start digging, you have like a last line of defense that tells you that if everything went south and the information that you got wasn't accurate, or you're doing something that is different a little from the plan, you can be safe and yet and still not hit any utilities. That's the idea.
Interesting. So what sort of depth limitations are we limited to? Are we talking, you know, a foot or 2 feet of soil? Are we only talking 4 to 6 inches? You know, how far down can the Rodradar bucket see into the ground?
First of all, the most important thing is that practically it's irrelevant. Why is it irrelevant? Because you dig, you're using the bucket, you're getting closer to the target all the time. So it doesn't matter what's the range. You need to know what's your safe space with your next bucket. Having said that, ideally, we detect everything down to 3 feet.
Oh, wow. That's far more depth than I was thinking.
Yeah, we detect everything down to 3 feet. But like in any other ground penetrating radar, everything affects your capability to detect, like the soil type, the utility type. So the more clayish, the less distance you see. The more metal, the better way the target can be separated from the background. And this is the part that I like most about our solution, is that on one hand, it's a cutting edge technology because there is no more advanced ground penetrating radar in the world now, and it's ours, LiveDig radar. That's on one hand. And on the second hand, there is a skill factor. You need to understand what you're doing. You need to adapt the way you work to the capabilities of the tool. And this is something that we've seen, that operators pick it up quite quickly and get very comfortable with using this tool.
So in my mind, this kind of would best be suited, even though you can see 3 feet in the ground, just for a safety factor. You would almost make your pass, set the bucket flat, drag it towards you, check for utilities, do another swipe with your bucket, check really quick, and that way you're just slowly working yourself down.
Exactly. We call this peeling the onion, and it really, really depends on what kind of soil type and how much at risk do you feel that you are. Okay, let's say that you're working in dry sand, you can peel up down to 20 or 30 centimeters, like 12 or 13 inches. But if you're working in clay and it is something that you really want to be making sure that you're going to avoid hitting, peeling layers of 5-6 inches at the time will give you a very, very good chance of not hitting this utility.
What an interesting tool. So let me ask you this, because we have electronics on this bucket, obviously. How quick is it to switch over if I'm, you know, let's say we found our utilities, we're good to go, but I'm digging in heavy rock. I don't want to beat up my Rodradar expensive bucket. How quickly can I switch between the Rodradar bucket and a conventional bucket?
But before we get into that, I want to take a second to tell you about the sponsor of this video, Chevron Lubricants. Protecting your diesel engine and its exhaust aftertreatment system has traditionally been seen as an either-or proposition when it comes to choosing the engine oil that's going to protect your system. And that's exactly why Chevron spent more than a decade of R&D work developing a no-compromise formulation. Now, I don't have to tell you why a clogged DPF is bad news, but here's the real kick in the pants. 90% of that ash clogging up your DPF and then upping your fuel and maintenance costs, it comes from your engine oil. You might be thinking, why don't they make an engine oil with less ash in it then? You'll be happy to learn that Chevron agrees with you. They've developed a new ultra-low ash diesel engine oil that is specifically designed to combat DPF ash clogging. Dello 600ADF with OmniMax technology cuts sulfate ash by 60%, radically reducing the rate of DPF clogging and extending the DPF service life by 2.5 times. Before, you had to choose between protecting your engine or your aftertreatment system. Now you don't. Dello 600ADF with OmniMax technology. It's time to kick some ash.
How quickly can I switch between the Rodradar bucket and a conventional bucket?
It's like any other bucket. The only addition is a connector that connects the system from the bucket to the cabin. That's the only difference. Down the line, we're planning to be connected with quick couplers and systems like this that will enable you to simply replace the bucket that you're digging with from the cabin.
So I am going to have to get out of the cab, but we're talking 10 seconds of unscrewing a connection and then you drop it like any other bucket.
Exactly. Even less.
No big deal at all. This is a pretty powerful tool. I'm sure it comes with a cost. Do you know roughly for a cost comparison what a conventional bucket would be versus one of the Rodradar buckets?
To compare between a conventional bucket and a radar bucket is unfair because it's not apples to apples. I don't know what are the prices of other tools. I can tell you that the price for an 8-ton machine in the United States is going to be somewhere in the whereabouts of $40,000.
Okay.
And we know from the people that are using the system that the ROI on the system is very, very quick. All you need to think about is the direct costs of hitting utilities. Okay, the fact that there's a damage that you need to prevent, there's a fine there, there's idle time, and all the costs that are associated with it. Also, you have to think about everything that you do for prevention. That does start with hydrovacking, sometimes surveying or hand digging, that you can do less. Okay, and I didn't talk about efficiency, but all you need to do is just add this up and think about how many strikes you could avoid, and how much more efficient could you be using this system. And we know that you get back your investment with a couple of months, and you're able to save hundreds of thousands of dollars if you're using the tool properly.
And that's kind of where my mind goes. You know, at initial knee-jerk reaction is, oh, $40,000, that's really expensive. But I sit here and think, first of all, very easily with one utility strike, you could absolutely save that in the fines you're going to get from whatever utility company you just hit. But more importantly, and where I think a lot of people aren't really mentally going to go right away, is every time we have to expose a line in the field, it's generally one to two labors coupled with a machine. And generally, you're putting your higher end operator in that machine because you're exposing utilities and you don't want to be responsible for a strike. And you've probably got 45 minutes to an hour of very slow hand digging, you know, depending on your situation with all the utilities in the ground. And no one's really taking into account just how much time I have in machine idle time and operator cost and laborer cost to slowly dig down and find those utilities. Versus with a tool like this, you could drop that time down to a fully exposed utility in 10 minutes, maybe. I feel like that's a huge savings.
I agree with you. We have a customer that already, when he's having his top crew that is exposing utilities, he was able to take one person that was hand digging and move him to another team. And this way he was already making more money with the same assets.
Yeah. The other area I go is, it's very common for us to get on private lots with private utilities that, unless you want to go fork out your own personal money and pass it through to the customer somehow, you have to hire a private locate service to come find those. They're not going to take into account things like sprinkler lines or propane lines, possibly. There's a lot of other things that you're going to have to worry about, versus this bucket can pick up all of those. And again, we're exposing those in a third to a fifth of the time that we would conventionally.
Yeah. That's exactly the case. And the issue is to gain confidence with the system and understand what it can and cannot do with you. And there's no other way to do that but simply, you know, use it.
Yeah.
It's a very, very powerful tool because the physics behind it are very paramount.
Well, Moshe, thank you so much for all the information. This sounds like a very capable tool. Where can people find more information on the Rodradar bucket?
First of all, we have a lot of information on our website, and we're currently working with our partner AMI Attachments from Ontario, Canada.
Okay.
That I believe that many of your followers know, and we are planning to make live dig radar for general availability down the line sometime early 2024. We're now getting the systems ready and so on and so forth.
Well, as always, thank you guys for watching The Dirt. Thank you for Rodradar and Moshe for taking his time to come on the show today to discuss this really awesome technology with us. As always, I hope this helps your business and gives you some insights as to how you can become more efficient. We'll catch you on the next episode of The Dirt.